Merry Christmas, everyone.
And welcome to the joy of the holiday season.
It's that time of year when spirits are high and all our dreams and fantasies can come true.
It's that time of year when the best things of all happen, with a little magic.
Dear Jean, we'd love to have you join us this year for our annual Christmas party. Just a small group of friends who are very dear to us both. Cordially, Richard and Karen. The invitations. The party's already starting.
Well, that's the magic of Christmas for you.
Yeah. Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas. Hey, Christy, long time no see.
You too, Karen.
You know, you and Richard are practically my second family. Or maybe I should say my third. Oh, well, enough of that. This is a member of my first family, my brother Jimmy.
Hi.
Hey, Jim. Make yourself at home.
You wouldn't have said that if you'd seen his room.
Thanks, Richard. I think I'll ignore my sister and work on yours.
Oh, thank you.
Hi.
Hi, Georgia. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. I saw the lights on, so I figured the party wasn't canceled. Am I early?
No.
Am I late?
No, you're right on time.
Awesome, oh, this is already the best party I've ever been to.
Thanks.
Come on in, Georgia. Merry Christmas.
You got room for one more?
No, I'm sorry, you're all filled up.
Well, I'm coming in anyway, because this is the best place to be at Christmas time, and besides, I've got presents for everyone.
Oh, good.
Hi, Christy.
Let me take your coat,
Jean. Thank you, Karen.
Jean, this is Jimmy, Jimmy, Jean.
Hi, Jimmy.
Richard,
here.
Richard, Jean, Jean.
Richard,
George,
how do you
Georgia,
do?
Jean.
Merry Christmas. Hello.
Did I miss anybody?
Bung, 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 bung.
Cubby, Jean, Jean, Danny, Danny, Jimmy, Bob, Jean, Georgia, Cubby, Doug, Richard, Richard, Jimmy. Boy, am I glad this only happens once a year.
Thank you.
Carpenters. A Christmas Portrait. Starring Richard and Karen Carpenter. With special guest star Gene Kelly. Georgia Engel. Christy and Jimmy McNichol. And introducing Peter Pitt.
With the chocolate cake?
Yeah. Okay, everybody, I know you're dying to get started. Time to get this thing rolling. Now, everybody's brought something to the party, right? Something to make Christmas a little merrier? I thought so. Who would like to go first? Well, let's not all jump at once now. Are you trying to tell me that I should go first? Okay. Yielding to popular demand, I thought that I would like to get the party officially underway with my gift. My gift, which happens to be, ta-da, cooking. I have found, over the years, the best way to get a party going is to make sure that people have enough food to eat. And that's when, and only when, they finally become more relaxed and they start to talk to each other.
Karen, how about some food? Everybody's hungry.
But you never ask.
She didn't have to hurry that much.
All right, you guys. Boy, I tell you, if there's one thing I've learned over the years, I always know where to find you. Right by the food.
Everything tastes great as usual, Casey.
Thanks, Doug. You like it now, you're going to love it after it's cooked. But if everyone else is going to enjoy my gift, you really have to leave me alone now, okay? So, out.
So you better watch out, you better not cry, better not call, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list
and checking it twice.
Gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town.
He sees you when you're sleeping, he knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good, so be good for goodness sake.
You better watch out, watch out, not cry, not cry. I'm telling you why, Santa Claus is coming to town.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh, all the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight.
Jingle, jingle
bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Oh,
what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Are great. I never seen them before.
Well, how could you see them before? You've never even been here before.
I thought they might be in an album cover or something. They're very good. right?
Well, thanks, Christy, but I'm afraid you'll never know what Karen and I go through selecting a picture for an album cover.
I'm sure Karen's a dream compared to Chrissy. It takes her so long to decide which picture to use that her album's number 50. Number 50 on the charts.
Before it even has a cover. It's very funny. I think it's important. What's important?
The picture and an album cover.
Well,
I never thought I'd hear that come out of your mouth.
What do you mean?
Oh, Rich, I have to drag you into the studio to take a picture. I mean, you'd rather be in the studio recording.
Oh, with us, it's just the opposite. I can't get Jimmy away from that mirror long enough to get him into the recording studio.
Hey, wait a minute. That's not true.
Oh, no.
And you
the
know
last
it.
Time we had a session, you know what happened? I disguised the microphone as a hairdryer to get him in there. No kidding.
Hey, well, I feel it's my artistic duty to look great. For the girls in America.
There you go, John.
I think we'd better give you our gift now before our big brothers get carried away.
I think you're right.
It's a very simple thing. I think it's one of the nicest gifts during Christmas time.
As a matter of fact, it's the same thing you're giving us.
A turkey?
No, our present is the love between brothers and sisters, the gift of family.
I think she was right the first time.
Are you calling me a turkey?
Hey, if the shoe fits, put on your drumstick.
Well, actually, he's crazy about me. Just has a hard time expressing himself.
Oh, that sounds real familiar.
Trust me, Christy, things can only get better with age.
I hope you're right.
When we were teenage, we went through a mean age. We think we know just what you mean. We were typical siblings with plenty of quibblings. I think we can sing you the scene.
Big brothers are supposed to be smart, so how come they act so dumb?
Big brothers are supposed to have feelings, but most of the time they're numb.
When we're looking for heroes, we usually find a clown.
We're supposed to look up to them,
so how come we're looking down?
Big brothers are supposed to be nice, so how come they act like nerds?
Setting an awful example, using X-rated words.
They're really gross, we diagnose them right for the local shrink.
Big brothers are not as big as they think.
Nag, 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 aren't they the worst?
The worst.
Kids, sisters, tell me, how come they act so dumb?
Kids, sisters, where do they get all the dumbness from?
She just won't leave me alone, always tagging after me.
What a bummer, I don't get no privacy.
Kids, sisters, who do you think babysits?
Hey, mister, don't you agree it's the
you're gonna grow up?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Wanna fight?
Yeah.
Big brothers,
kids,
are supposed
sisters,
to be nice, so how come they act like nerds? Setting an awful example.
Don't you agree it's the
words? They're really gross, we diagnose them
kind
right
of a love and shrink.
Or a medal.
Big brothers,
kids,
big
sisters,
are not
when you're
as
gonna
big
grow
as they
up.
Think.
That was yesterday.
Yesterday.
And today.
And today.
We can say.
We can say.
That as a number ends.
As it ends.
We're what every sister and brother should hopefully be.
All together.
The very best of friends.
Christmas rushes through, but I still have one wish to make. The a special one for you. Merry Christmas, darling. We're apart, that's true. But I can dream, and in my dreams, I'm Christmasing with you. Holidays are joyful, there's always something new. But every day's a holiday. The lights on my tree, I wish you could see. I wish it every day. The logs on the fire fill me with desire to see you and to say that I wish you Merry Christmas.
I've got a theory about Christmas presents.
That it's more blessed to give than to receive?
Well, that and more.
That it's not the gift, it's the thought that counts?
Well, that's part of it. But what my theory is, you might even call it Kelly's Law, is that people give it to others what they would most like to receive themselves.
Yeah, that makes sense to me.
Well, Jimmy and I gave the gift to family, and that means a lot to us.
Wait a second. I'm giving everybody food.
Now, you may think that you're just giving us all food, but I think of it as the golden gift of hospitality and warmth, the very sustenance of joy itself, the daily bread from which all the sandwiches of life are sliced.
Is that really what she's been doing? Or have you been kissing the Blarney Stone again?
Oh, you noticed, huh? Well, actually, I'm warming up to give you my Christmas present. It's a story. It's about the best way to celebrate Christmas you and I could ever know. Next to this one, of course. And the greenest.
The greenest?
Yes, the greenest. Now, Miss McNichol, what is the greenest, sweetest place in all the world?
Ireland.
Right. And Miss McGingle, what's the friendliest spot in the greenest place in all the world?
Killarney.
Perfect so far. And you, Miss O'Carpenter, are you ready for the gift of old Erin?
Ready, Mr. O'Kelly.
I bring you a gift from the side of old Erin, a shamrock to wear on St. Nicholas Day. And clogs for your feet are what you should be wearing to celebrate Christmas the old country way.
for you, Richard. And you, Jimmy. And Karen.
Thank you.
And Georgia.
The holly green, the ivy green, the prettiest picture you've ever seen is Christmas in Killarney with all of the folks back home. It's nice to know to kiss your beau cuddling under the mistletoe, for Santa Claus, of course you know, is one of the boys from home. The door is always open, the neighbors pay a call, a drop of cheer is always here to welcome one and all. How grand it feels to click your heels and join in the fun of the jigs and reels, and a new no blarney the likes you've never known is Christmas in Killarney with all of the folks back home. After the song, it's time for a dance. Just gather round, you'll all get a chance. Mind the step and mind the meter, just like playing follow the leader. First you slide and slide and slide, then skippity skipping the heel and the toe. Part of us, then swing your partner to and fro. Karen, you're the first to go. Have never known. It's Christmas in Killarney with all the folks at home.
The Carpenters, a Christmas portrait. We'll continue in a moment.
Okay, Rich, it's your turn. What'd you bring to the party?
Funny you should ask, because I've got a problem about that.
Oh.
Not a big problem, but a problem.
You mean you didn't bring anything? Is that it?
No, not exactly. You see, I believe a person should give what he himself loves the most.
Oh, great. Jimmy'll have to give up his comb.
Okay, I'll give up my comb. You give up your nightlight.
Cute.
No, that's not quite what I meant either. I brought a present for everyone, but I couldn't wrap it, or put your names on it, or put it under the tree.
I hope it fits in my car.
You couldn't wrap it?
You couldn't put our names on it?
Couldn't fit it under the tree.
Oh, wait a second. I think I've got it. I think. Yeah?
Yeah.
Good! Well, you picked the perfect thing.
I'm glad you like it.
Ladies and gentlemen, my brother, Richard, has brought us all the gift of music.
Thank you.
can't imagine who it could be.
Better find out.
Maybe it's Santa Claus a little early.
Or the Easter Bunny a little late.
Hi! Hey! How are you? Merry Christmas! How you doing? Come on in. Hey, everybody, say hi to my parents.
Hi! Hi.
Merry Christmas.
Come on in.
We can't stay, Karen, but we wanted to come by and wish everyone a Merry Christmas.
Well, that was nice.
Well, I'm glad you did. Let me take those.
Yeah. You can certainly stay long enough just to meet one person, I hope. You're gonna flip when you meet this person. Don't move, I'll be right back. Hi, would you come here for a second?
Well, sure.
Jean Kelly, this is my mom and dad.
Hello, how do you do? It's
glad
a pleasure to meet you. I must say, you've certainly raised a couple of very talented children.
Thank you. We think so, too.
And they've raised a couple of very nice parents. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Pleased to have met you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jean. Well? What do you think? Is he something?
Oh, great. I just can't wait to tell my friends that Gene Kelly kissed me.
Oh, I bet.
Yeah, he's a pretty smart man. He knows a beautiful woman when he sees one, all right?
Listen, I'm really glad you stopped by.
Oh, enjoy.
You have a good time wherever you're going, okay?
Thank you.
Don't stay out too late.
Okay.
I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Have
good night.
Have a wonderful party.
Thank you. Good night.
You like what I brought to the party?
Well, I'm sure we will, Georgia.
Actually, you don't have much choice, do you? The stores are all closed.
That's true.
Except the drug stores. They're still open. But I don't like to give cotton.
I don't blame you.
Unless someone specifically has it on their Christmas list.
Very few people do.
I know.
I'm sure your present will be wonderful.
Then I better give you these now while we're all feeling happy.
Oh, they're adorable. Thank you.
They're angels.
Oh, they certainly are.
The lady in the angel store said they're scale models. but I don't believe her. I think it was just a sales hype. And like a ninny, I fell for it.
I'm glad you did. Yeah,
great, thank you. I didn't bring angels for the men. Do you think they'll mind?
I don't think so.
Good. What do they need angels for? They've got us.
George, you've added the perfect touch to our Christmas party.
Oh, thank you.
Enjoying the presents we share with our close friends and families.
But it's also nice to think about the gifts that people all over the world have given us.
And we mean the wonderful carols that are a part of our Christmas enjoyment every year.
Yes, for instance, Adeste Fideles. Sometimes we sing it as O Come All Ye Faithful. But it was originally a Latin hymn written in 1750 by an English scholar living in France. Which proves once again that Christmas and its music are universal and timeless.
Adeste fideles, laeti triumphantes, venite.
Oh, come let us. us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Silent Night was written the afternoon before Christmas in 1818 in Austria. The organ in St. Nicholas Church in Oberndorf had broken, and in order to provide music for the evening services, Franz Gruber wrote this carol to be performed, as it was that very evening, by two singers with just a single guitar accompanying them.
Over the years, the melody has changed, but tonight we'd like to do the original version.
Stille Nacht, heilige Nacht, alles schläft, einsam wacht, nur das traute hochheilige Paar, ohne Knabe im lockigen Haar, schlaf in himmlische Ruhe, schlaf in himmlische
trace the word carol back far enough, you'll find that it originally meant a kind of circle dance without words. Folk dancing has always been a part of Christmas celebration, especially in the rhythm and melody of the Spanish carol, Fum Fum Fum.
Nace guapo a nuestro amor, el niño Dios, hoy de la Virgen María, en esa noche tan fría, fum, fum, fum. On December 25, fum, fum, fum. On December 25, fum, fum, fum. There was born a little child, so pink and white, so sweet and mild. In a manger poor and lonely, son of Mary, virgin holy, fum, 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 fum.
Ave Maria, Hail Mary, were the first words spoken by the angel Gabriel to Mary in the Gospel according to St. Luke.
Though the Ave Maria has been set to music many times, one version was composed by Charles Gounod, a Frenchman, to a prelude by Bach, a German, for all the world to love.
Oh.
The Carpenters, A Christmas Portrait, brought to you by Best Foods, makers of Hellman's and Best Foods mayonnaise, Mazola corn oil, Mazola margarine, Skippy peanut butter, and other fine products.
Now that we've shared our gifts, we'd like to thank all of you for being with us again this year.
And a very special thanks to our guests, Christy and Jimmy McNichol. Georgia Engel. Our group. And Mr. Gene Kelly.
And that spirit hovering over the party was our new friend, Peter Pitt. Without whom it would have been a lot less magical.
Our party's going to go on now, and we hope yours does too. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Happy New Year. God bless you all.
Good night.
Tomorrow night on 8 is Enough, Abby thinks Tom is seeing another woman. Then, Charlie's Angels go to the races to find out why a big-time gambler got left dead at the starting gate. And on Vegas, Dan Tanna tries to help a tennis superstar shake the mob. Now, stay tuned for Starsky and Hutch, next on ABC.
Chicago, Max Rock.